ladies and gentlemen, with our next presenter, who is waiting already in our virtual hall. He's in Suprema since 2013. SEAL headquarters said, well, he has some great experience in engineering and solutions, so we want to have him. From 2017, he has set up Suprema Europe, which is stated in Paris, and now he can talk about and share his knowledge throughout the North Africa and, of course, whole Europe. What will he be talking about? What is actually a closed contact lens solutions? Where do we go with that? What has changed throughout the year? And what is the future? How fast are we moving in something which was always like, hello, please check in, put your name, surname, your address, write it down, give me your ID or something. What has changed in that? We're going to know right now. It's my great pleasure to introduce you, Sales Director of Europe at Suprema, Ms. Baudouin-Genouille. Bonjour et bienvenue à Sarajevo.
Hello, thank you very much for the introduction. Can you hear me?
Of course, I can hear you now. If you're ready, we can wait for your presentation. So please be the new normal guy for us today.
Okay, thank you very much. Cenkuye. This is a long time I didn't say this. This is 1 year I've been waiting for saying Cenkuye again. Thank you again for Addis for organizing this. It's always a pleasure for Suprema to attend this this show. So this keynote will be about the new normal, especially the credentials that are used in access control. And this is a presentation that will last for 30 minutes, and I will try to keep 5 minutes for the question, just as Jakub did previously. Before I start with the agenda and the topic, some words about Suprema. We are a South Korean company. We are a manufacturer specialized into access control. We have a specialty also in time attendance, identity. And for example, we have this, put in front of my face, this BioMini USB fingerprint matcher that you can install for unlocking your Windows session or giving you access to some transaction software. We also have some alarm integration, and overall we work with all the security industry. You see this small logo on the bottom, which is a 20, because founding year was 2000, so it's a little bit more than 20 years that we are in business. Let's shine a little bit. We are we have been ranked just last month, or maybe in February, first in access control, ranked by the ANS readers, ANS magazine readers. So we've been ranked first for access control software and for our mobile credentials as well. And by AHS report analysis company, we have the first share for the biometrics in access control for Europe and Middle East. And Europe region is a big part of our business, because it represents almost one fourth of our business, and that was the last year turnover. So Suprema is a manufacturer. We do reliable hardware with good quality and dedicated to access control. This includes, as you can see on screen, readers, door controllers, and accessories. So we push ourselves to make a good design, and we are targeting mid-end and high-end. So that means that we are going to be same price, or maybe more expensive, a little bit less expensive than product from USA or from Europe. And of course, we will be a little bit more expensive than products that you can purchase from China or cheaper origins. To have all these readers and hardware working together, we have a software which is called BioStar, which is based on a web-based user interface with a mobile application, so you can interact with the access control software from your mobile phone, with your iOS phone, as you say, or with Android phone. We have integration, so we have integration with Genetec that was just talking before us. Jakub knows about it, and we have also deep integration in place. We have server APIs if you want to be able to connect this access control system to some other database. And we manage all RFID and Bluetooth credentials as well. So this is a shiny slide, and I'm finished with this short introduction. So this was 2 months or 1 month ago that readers from ASMAG were requested to vote for a pool, which is the access control software that you prefer. And we were lucky to be the first one. So that's why we're working hard to be the first ones to provide the best service to our customer. And that's a very thank you that I want to say to these voters from ASMAG. And we got the same ranking also with the mobile access, and this will be part of the credential discussion that I will have with you today. So what is this presentation for? What it will answer? Of course, you can ask your questions. I'm waiting for a question to answer at the end of this presentation. But the scope of the new normal is, let's say I have a new project that I want to install, or maybe upscope or retrofit. So what is the best technology to install? What would Suprema recommend? Installing keys or card or QR code or PIN code or biometrics? What should I install? What are the differences? And I will answer this. I do not understand what is secured and what is not secure. Baudouin, can you please explain me what you mean by secured and what is not secure? And are there, when installing this system or these credentials, will there be any legal limitation from government that this can be installed in some cases and this cannot be installed? So I will answer these questions. I hope it's all clear for you. And let's start with a little case to put something more straightforward to this presentation. Let's take the case of a Pentagon building. And this is our house, this is our building, the building we protect. And let's say that not all area in this building require equality in terms of security. So let's say the area around, for example, the parking or the welcoming desk is blue, low security, and you have some areas that are orange that require more security, and high security area in red that will require higher security tools. So of course, the credential will follow these 1, 2, 3 layers, meaning that you will need to adapt the hardware and the software that you put in these different zones. And the best solution is a solution that will be able to provide a comprehensive and stable solution, mixing all these different level of credentials. So you can see your fingerprint, face, PIN and card, which are the most common. And here I come to the agenda of this presentation. I will first talk about the blue area, the less secure, that is very suitable for using credential like QR code. Then I will talk about the orange area, about the RFID badge and mobile. So two technology in badge, the low frequency, 125 kilo, and the high frequency, 13.56 megahertz. And finally, I will talk about the red, the critical area that most of time require higher security, like biometric technology. And I will develop it about 2D fingerprint and touchless face recognition. Let's start with the QR code. So this is a very simple credential with a simple image. So this is example of email that I have received when I went to incubator in Paris, which is called Station F. And I was invited to join for a meeting there. And this is the email I received with the QR code. I was able to show this email on my phone, and I was able to enter the first layer of the building thanks to this invitation. So of course, it's a simple credential. It can be copied. It's free because this is just a picture that you need to send, but it's very convenient. So in my understanding, and what I would like to say about this is that it's very suitable for visitors or first layers before users will have to come to a registration desk It allows them to access the parking area or the first layer of the building without too much burden and no much waiting list, and it's free. So that's a good point of it. You don't have to buy it. And here this is a product of Suprema that we launched very recently, which is called X Station 2. On the same product, so the QR code is kind of an option that you can plug below. You also have on the top of it the possibility to use the same device as well for employees or visitors after they have registered on desk to use credentials such as RFID plastic card, just like the one I'm showing you right now. So this is X-Station 2. So after we have discussed about the less secure, let's talk about the secure part, which is using RFID. And this is a very short presentation of the... I'm still waiting for the slide to update. The RFID. So RFID in recent credential history started in 1960 with a magnetic stripe. So we don't see too much these cards nowadays in Europe, sometimes in some hotels, but you can still see a lot in the US. Then came the vegan card, and now we have more modern RFID cards, such as the one from NXP, MyFair EV1, EV2, EV3, as well as HID CEOs cards that came out in 2014. So I want to make a distinction between two worlds. It's like for photography, you have the black and white picture when like you know, the black and white camera that we used to have, which is the old world that still some people are using. And there is a color world that like we take a color picture now with our phones, which is represented by the credential on the right, the RFID card on the right. So why I make distinction between these two cards? Because if you represent these different type of cards on a chart with security level on the axis x axis and price on the other y axis, these low frequency card 125 kilohertz, the black and white, what I call the black and white, are in unsafe zone. What unsafe means is that it can be copied easily. So I will show you in next slide. You just need to invest 20 euro or $20 in some hardware that you can find easily, and you will be able to copy these cards, which make it unsafe. That means that somebody can steal your credential and copy it and use it to penetrate into the facilities. On the other hand, you have this colored card, which I call the safe zone, with all these cards. And what I recommend and what is the trend, what we have seen, I will show you a graphic about this, is that there is a slow migration from the unsafe zone to the safest zone. The problem is that it comes with a cost. When you want to get rid of a low frequency card and use the high frequency, the card is more expensive. Maybe it's 1 euro for the unsafe and it will be four euro for the safe. But also sometimes you have also to change your installation and that reflects with Jakub PowerPoint before, which was talking about obsolescence or some site, which is a concern for users. So this comes with a cost and you will have to change your hardware or your readers or software maybe. Interesting things is that there are positive migration and negative migration. And one positive migration would be that you also have the possibility to use mobile credential. And the interesting thing is that mobile is a high secure credential and it's less expensive than most of the safe zone credential. So this is a very good way to save cost and increase security. So why unsafe zone? Because, and this is my takeout, so I've got 6 points for the takeout for RFID. My first takeout is avoid this 125 kilohertz. Please don't install this for new projects. And if you already have it installed, have a plan to update progressively. The reason why is this is Amazon. You see the price here, which is 13, let's say 14 euro. For 14 euro, you can buy a copier and you can buy cards. And that means that if one of your employees leaves card on the desk, I just have to come, copy, paste, and I can use this card to enter the building when he's not in there. So please don't use this low frequency cards. This is number one. Number two, you should use the safe zone and this MyFair 13.56 or equivalent HID cards. And you have to use it with care because many end users, many system installers, to make it simple, they are still using the CSN, the card serial number, which is something that everybody can read on the card. So please don't use the CSN, use SecureID, which means that on the card, you are going to encode and encrypt UID, which is user ID. For example, my ID will be 2645, and I will be able to put this number. It will be encrypted with a key, and nobody can read it. You need to know the key in order to open this card. My third takeout is ask yourself what is the technology I'm using. So for this, you have a very simple app which is called Tag Info. You can find on iOS or on Google, and it allows to know what is your card, what is the version of your card, and is it a secure card. For some cards, of course, you will not be able to read with your phone. This is a low frequency card, and for this, Suprema proposes you to check it with our reader and software. Ask yourself if you have a multiple layer of security. Is there a cache room? Is there in this laboratory some places where there are some expensive document or expensive device that you need to protect better? And ask yourself what is appropriate for each zone. Number four takeout is that check your freedom of level with the system you have or the system you will install. First question being, are you able or free to migrate? So some manufacturers sell you the card at the same time they sell you the access control. And if you want to change a card, it will not be compatible with your access control. So this is something you have to check if you know the keys, how to access your card. And second question about this takeout four is, will your system be able to handle multiple formats? And this is about the migration I've been discussing. So what you see here, sometimes you have readers that can only read low frequency. Sometimes they can only read high frequency, but only a specific type of high frequency. So this is time for me to introduce this XPath, three design, but two different version, XPath 2, which is a reader plus a door controller, and the D2, which is a dummy reader. D stands for dummy, which is just an antenna that you can put on any controller you have already installed, which has RF options, combining everything possible. So you have low frequency, high frequency, MyFair, MyFair Plus, Deathfire, EV1, EV2, and you have the possibility to use NFC and BLE. So it's a reader that is completely capable to use your old card, migrate to more secure, and also use the mobile if you have the possibility to use this mobile. As a takeout number five, cards are very simple in terms of law and privacy. We were talking about GDPR and legislation. So there is no big concern to have with cards, so you can be as the guy on the picture smiling. My last takeout about RFID is about mobile cards. So I think mobile card is the best choice when you are lucky that your user, they have a smartphone that they can use. Because this mobile card, of course you understood, is low cost, high security, and easy to manage. And it's about digitalization. So everything is about digitalization these days. When you have a RFID card that you gave to a visitor, then you need to get this card back. Sometimes they lose it. You need to cancel it, to blacklist this card. It's when you have student, they forgot to give you back the card, so it costs you one more card. It's complicated. So best choice is mobile. And at Suprema, we have two ways of doing our licensing model for mobile card. The first one, we call it regular, which is for companies and fixed workers, very simple. One card, one credit. So you have one new worker, you consume one credit. The second model is the blue, is dynamic, is that you pay per doors or per access point you have. So let's say I have a building of 10 doors. I will pay 10 credits per month, every month. But then I can give cards to as much user as I want, 5,300. And I can issue this card, reissue this card. I can delete. I can pause this card. I can validate, change the valid date without any cost. So this is very interesting in cases of fitness, membership, shared place, universities, or stuff like this. So two models, regular or dynamic, both of them working with a kind of a credit, credit per card or credit per door. You can customize, so this application is available. You need to install application on your phone to use the mobile card. And this application allows you to have a specific design of your card with the logo of the company, which makes it really your card, different from others. And for those who don't have the possibility to invest into buying new readers and changing the system, we have this also this AirFob patch, which is a sticky patch that you will stick on the readers and will activate Bluetooth. Communication, so you can use Bluetooth with your mobile phone. It needs to be sticked on readers with high frequency, 13.56 megahertz. So you don't need to change all your installation. You just put this sticky AirFob patch, and it will power on the RFID. So you don't need to bring power. It's very simple and easy to install. AirFob patch. So as a conclusion for badge. Still, a lot of Rox card in Europe. Smart cards, high frequency is gaining traction, and mobile is the future. But still, it's changing smoothly. No big change, but a trend that will continue, and the trend that will be that you like Zoran from in Croatia from Fidens, you will use your watch to open doors. It's not a problem. Last thing about biometric technology for the more secure areas, so red areas, is why biometric is a more secure credential. Because the card is what you have, a PIN is what you know, and biometric is what you are. So it's really you. At the end, you have to understand biometrics is we're taking an image and we process this image into minutiae model of you. And at the end, this is just a number that will be stored in a database. So we don't store a raw image and face. In order to know if it's you, we compare the number that will be given when seeing your face or finger to a database of templates, a database of numbers. So biometrics is probability. If the same numbers goes again, we say it's the same person. The concern for biometric in Europe are multiple and related to GDPR. So you have to know that you can store biometric on smart cards and secure smart cards. You can store your fingers. You can store your face. When using the new FaceStation F2 on smart cards, I recommend PV2, and it's encrypted as you can see on picture here. We also have privacy by design for GDPR that if you don't store on smart card but on device itself, then you have the possibility to use the secure tamper. That is a free option. And if somebody takes a device out of the wall, everything on the device will be reset to factory default. So logs, user, encryption, and template will be lost. So now what is the changes in the use of biometric credential in Europe for the 5 years? There was the trend is always that fingerprint has been the number one used credential. And I will explain why. And the second trend is that facial is smoothly taking over fingerprints and also accelerating for this last year in 2019. So the reason why fingerprint is at the upper end is very simple. if you look at some category, consistency, accuracy, security, convenience, and price, you see that fingerprint is a favorite authentication method, and it beats everything. The reason why face has been growing before 2020 is because of technology and performance has been increased at no cost. So that concerns CPU, processors, and infrared. And we have seen this change in the industry and since 2015. So that's why at Suprema, we have this old product, FaceStation, that is from 2011, that is discontinued. And last year, the best sellers for Suprema in Europe has been the FaceStation 2, that was designed some 5 years ago, the FaceLite, and the FaceStation F2, which is a new device we have. So you can expect something to come in 2022 on Face as well, since this is very hard and moving trend. The reason for the growing of face in 2020 is that number one is touchless. Number two, the technology and the performance has increased. So now the false acceptance rate when you put your face on a FaceStation F2 is 1 in 10 billion. So that means that there is 1 in 10 billion risk that the same face, somebody can show his face and can usurpate somebody else's identity. The good thing is also you can authenticate with mask and gloves, which is very adapted to current situation. And you can also detect the presence of a mask. You can check if employees are wearing their mask or in buildings. And you can also detect abnormal body temperature with an add-on. So something that was added, which is a thermal camera. So it's this face recognition is an appropriate answer to a complex problem. This is almost the end. I just want to say that Suprema will be everywhere for the next 3 days. So that's why I put every logo everywhere. We have some side events. Please take a screenshot. And if you want to know more about the software, about the case application or case study, we have these three events below. Please have fun for these 3 days and don't hesitate to ask some questions. I think we have 2 minutes remaining. Sorry for this. Please go on for the questions.
Merci beaucoup pour ça. This was great because I am the guy who always wanted to visit a lot of places and I hate filling out the forms. So some great stuff for us. Not professionals in the industry, but of course a great solutions for everybody who will use it in very strange places like Pentagon. Congratulations for that one. I also have 2 questions prepared for you, Baudouin. So first one is this. Has the pandemic changed the dominant trends in the use and purchase of various types of credentials?
Yeah, so as I've shown it, we haven't seen a big change for the RFID part. So the trend is always the same, a little bit less unsecure and more secure. And this is thanks to all the industry that is pushing forward the end user to understand what can be hacked and what cannot be hacked. And Genetec is part of it and is very good for this. So the main change of the pandemic and impact was on the biometrics is that we still sell the same number of fingerprint devices, so there is no issue with this. I think people have understood that when they come to office, they will touch locks and things, and they wash their hands, so they can also touch a fingerprint sensor and wash their hand after. But a lot of traction, a lot of interest for facial recognition. You can imagine in hospitals, in a place where you want to vaccine people, that this is very interesting to have the possibility to authenticate your employee with a touchless solution. If you are a doctor and you want to come and open the door, you don't have to remove your gloves, you don't have to take a card, you don't have to remove your mask. So this is very adapted to current situation. So yeah, a lot of face. And I was showing numbers, but for Suprema, maybe three years ago, Face was 10% of our turnover. Now Face is becoming like 35% of our turnover, which is very important. And we believe in the future, it can be up to 50% of our turnover with facial recognition, so for access control.
Okay, thank you for this answer. The next one is quite new for all the users of modern technology, because after the Facebook was breakdown by the hackers, everybody talks about the privacy. So, as a professional, what do you say? How do we balance on the privacy concerns with the need for convenience and more efficiency?
This is, like I said, with the Pentagon, so you have to adapt. Maybe it's not needed to put, it depends on countries. So I've been working in South Korea for some years, and there the privacy has concern, but less. I didn't have any keys for the 6 years I was living in Korea. I got two keys. This was for my bicycle lock and my wife's bicycle as well. But for coming back home, I didn't use keys. I had RFID. For going to office, I was using biometrics, and everywhere I was using new technology that doesn't need any keys. But you have countries like France or Germany, or maybe also Poland, that are not so keen on with using biometrics. So first, you have to adapt to the law of the country. This is number one. So if the country laws is more important than the law, if your employees are not happy with using fingerprint or face because they feel like they are going to be too much checked, it's very fine to use a mobile or RFID. So you have, like for the Pentagon, you have to adapt the situation to your country and to the building. So if there are some drugs in the hospital, of course you should be using biometrics, and people, they will understand. They have to show their face or fingerprint to open the drugs where the morphine or some other drugs are. Same thing if it's a cash room. In a McDonald's where you have the cash, etc., you will understand that you have to use biometrics. But maybe on the first door, you don't need to use biometric. A card or mobile is enough. So I think you need to adapt the response to the moral, the legislation, and the security layer that is required for this perimeter.
Maybe we have to explain to the legislators that when the unwanted representatives of the family are in front of the door, you just do it like slide goodbye. Thank you so much, Vidvan, for this, and hope to see you again live in Sarajevo or any other town of the Central East Europe where we do the summit.
Thank you very much. Thank you, everybody.
No, merci beaucoup. Bye. Pour tout.